Good morning. And I'm just doing this short wee quick intro, and excuse the attire, but I wanted to have a wee word with you before the main day sort of kicks off. The morning, let's just say it's just after 6 o'clock in the morning. And as you can see, I'm probably not even fully dressed yet. It's a slight breeze, so I hope you can hear me over the any wind noise on the camera. But I'm here, I'm outside with my coffee. And I just wanted to say that it's really quite strange about a boating holiday. You don't mind getting up at silly o'clock in the morning. I mean, any other holiday, you know, and you would be like getting up at like 6:30, you know, you would be, it would be very irritating, you know, but on a boarding holiday you don't mind. And I'll tell you the reason why. Okay, I'm gonna spin round and show you what I'm watching just now. Now, I don't know if you can see that, okay? That is the Fair Sovereign. That's our boat. I don't think I've shown you the boat yet, okay? But that's what I'm sitting watching. The sun is rising just over those trees there, and it is glorious, you know? Yes, it's a bit chilly. There is still a wee bit of a breeze, you know, but after the heavy rain, the high winds, and at times a quite rather boisterous adventure we have yesterday, it really is a beautiful morning, you know. And you could, as I'm actually talking to you, you're just actually seeing the sun creep over those crested trees and actually come into the day. And this is what it is about a boating holiday, you know. You really don't mind because you get such wonderful vistas. You know, it's so calm, it's so peaceful, you know. I can't really show on the camera, but the fish in the river are just sort of popping up for their morning breakfast, you know, and then just sort of diving back down. And it's so beautiful, you know. And this is why I love boating so much, you know. It's just amazing, you know, just things that you see that you would never see just in your normal everyday sort of life, or probably most other holidays, unless you actually make a concerted effort. You know, on a boating holiday, you just see that naturally, and that's fantastic, you know? Anyway, I'll give you a wee look at the boat. You know, that's the boat there. She's a fly bridge, so there's a bridge up there, a helm up there, and a helm inside, you know. I'll show you the front of it if I can pull myself away from the glorious sunrise that's happening. We were joined last night by a few other boats. That's the front of it. That funny wee thing, dome, just there on the front of the boat, that's actually the satellite tracking system for the FreeSat TV. Which is also odd, because we've not been putting a TV on, you know? I mean, what's this? This is day 4, I think? Yeah, you lose track of time. and nobody's put TV on at all. We did watch the Star Wars movie last night, but we didn't last. But I'll go through all that later on in the proper introduction. This is just a sort of a pre-introduction, I'll call it. Okay, but anyway, back to the boat. So that's the satellite tracking. And that's the boat there. Bedroom in the front, en suite. Bedroom in the back, en suite. With a jacuzzi bath, can you believe? A jacuzzi bath on a boat. I mean, we've not used it yet, but I think we might. So yeah, that's the boat. We were joined by a couple of others last night, just over there. And I'll just give don't know if anybody would be interested in the name of that, Pink Gin, you know. But yeah, that is what I'm watching with my morning cuppa, and it's glorious, absolutely fantastic. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with you before we all got sort of active and organised and what have you. So so until later, when I've actually got some clothes on and we decide what we're doing proper for today, I shall speak to you later. So I'll speak to you later, but before I go, I'll give you one more look at this glorious sunrise.
That's a lovely way to start the morning blog, isn't it? yes, hello, I'm back. Probably looking just a little bit better than what I was earlier on, in the sense that I'm now dressed. Still not washed or anything like that, but that will come. There's a reason for that, is that we're going to have a bit of an early start and we're going to dive up to Norwich. And we're going to spend a day in Norwich. The sooner we can get up there, the more time we've got to spend. We might even take a wee sort of a wee detour into Sirling and Broad, my favourite place in the Broads. see what wonders and delights are in Norwich. It's only a couple of hours up the river, but the earlier we could get there, the more time we've got to spend. Not sure yet if we're going to be spending the night in Norwich, or if we will leave and go elsewhere and spend the night. The Norwich Yacht Station is right beside a busy main road in the centre, so it might be a wee bit noisy, I don't know. But we shall discuss this with Tony and Lorna and see what they think. Yeah. So that is our plan for today. It's Norwich, we're just about to get underway. So it's looking lovely today so far. The sun is definitely trying to come out. There's a few clouds about, but it's definitely nowhere near as I don't know what you would call it yesterday, boisterous the weather yesterday. The time is currently 8:25. Hopefully we'll be in Norwich by about 10:30 at the latest, give or take. And it's going to be great. So until something else happens, I'll speak to you later. Okay, yes, hello. Right, that is us in Norwich. We've just arrived at Norwich York Station maybe about 45 minutes, an hour ago. It's a bit of a shock to the senses, coming back from the peace, quiet and tranquility of the rivers, right next to the main road where there's buses, cars, noisy motorbikes, emergency services belting up and down. So, yeah. Tony and Lorna were thinking, you know, well, once we got to Norwich, have a wander around, you know, and it's perfectly fine staying in Norwich overnight, you know. I did tell them about the main road, but they were like, oh no, it'll be fine. But yeah, here now, moored up. Yeah, we're not staying in Norwich, I don't think. That might change, but the universal opinion is that we will go somewhere where it's just a little bit quieter, a little bit more scenic and peaceful and tranquil. So there's a place about an hour or so back down the river called Brampton Common. So we passed that, plenty of space, it's on the main river, and you know, it's nice and green and all that, so yeah. I think that could be where we are going later on. I'm only saying this because I keep catching myself, you know, You would think after 4 days of doing this, you know, I would have an idea, you know, about what not to do, you know, but I keep doing the same mistakes over and over, which is basically I keep doing it, and also I keep forgetting to look at the lens, you know, and talk to you, you know. I'm having a wee bit of a problem. I keep having a wee look about, you know, and it looks like I'm not talking to you, but I am talking to you, so I must remember, look at the lens more often on the camera. So yes, we will probably be going to Brampton Common. Tony and Lorna are currently away for a wee wander around the city centre of Norwich. So I am going to fill up with water. I've just had a shower and washed and dressed and fresh clothes on. So I'm going to fill up with water, top up the water tanks. I was kind of hoping for a pump out the day, because that's been about 3 days, but unfortunately the pump out at the Norwich York Station is out of order. So that's not a problem at the moment, but I will definitely need to worry about a pump out in the next couple of days, because the last thing we want is the waste tank backing up. Oh, that would be bad news, yes. So yeah, we'll have to get a pump out organised in the next day or two on the way back down the river. But it's not a problem at the moment. So what am I going to do? Well, like I said, I'm going to fill up with water, top up the water tanks, make sure so that's all dealt with. It takes a wee while. And then I am going to go for a wee wander and go down to Norwich Cathedral. I thought I'd have a wee look at the cathedral. That's supposed to be a really nice wee place. So that's just down the river a wee bit. And yeah, we'll take a wee look at the cathedral, and as always, hopefully I'll maybe be able to bring you along as well. So that's my plan for the day, and we will be all meeting back on the boat in about 2 or 3 hours, you know, and then we'll just probably decide if we are definitely going to go down to Brampton Common, or if they want to actually stay here, beside all the hustle and the bustle and the noise and everything. So yeah, that's the update so far. The weather is it's dry. Let's say that it's remaining dry, but the clouds have come over. It's not too windy, nowhere near as bad as it was yesterday, but there's definitely a slight breeze, which is why I'm doing a lot of this stuff in the boat. But there's a right nip to the air, you know. It's really quite chilly. So far we've not actually been up top for
today, and we were very weren't up top much at all yesterday, which is a bit of a shame, but you know, that's what April is. You know, you're never entirely sure what the weather's going to be like in April. You know, we could have got lucky. You know, I don't think we're too bad. You know, it's been very changeable, but it's not. It's cold, it's wet, it's windy some days, and then we get beautiful sunrises and gorgeous sunsets, and the wind dies down, and it's all calm at night. So, yeah, it's been a bit of everything, So yeah, but 4 days in, how am I enjoying the holiday? Fantastic. Brilliant. This is why I love boating holidays. This is why I come on boating holidays. Excuse me while I change the hand. So everything is going fantastic at the moment. It's been everything that I always expect from a boating holiday. You know, peaceful, relaxing, tranquil, really calming, you know. So I'm going to go now. I've probably babbled on a wee bit too much. Change the battery in the camera, because for the first time I've actually used all the battery power. And get myself organised, top up with water, and I will probably speak to you, probably, hopefully, around about the cathedral area. So, until then, I shall speak to you later. Alright? Okay, I feel a wee bit daft. saying anything just now. I'm currently in the incredibly unbelievable and quite awe-inspiring Norwich Cathedral, and it is massive. I had no idea that so long ago they could build places this it's not just huge, it's intricate detail in everything, and it's got the largest pipe organ I have ever seen. I'll just spin you around and I'll show you the pipes at the moment. Now that is the pipes of the organ, and they are huge, you know, and it goes all, and just, it's like the pipes of the organ are massive, and yet look how big the ceiling is. I mean, it's just, the place is unbelievably. But it's not just that, I mean, it's like, it is very busy at the moment. There's obviously something going on. There seems to be peregrines nesting in the spires outside, and this has seemed to have triggered off some sort of, I'm assuming it's a local thing, but there's a lot of kids out, there's a lot of families here. They've got telescopes set outside in a tent with a hawk and owl society focused on the nest. So it is quite busy, and it's not as quiet as I imagine it would usually be. But I can imagine that when it is quiet, you know, and it's very peaceful, this would be a serene place, you know, and quite, I don't know how it is, it's quite calming, you know, I mean, quite humbling as well, place to be, you know, but this is an amazing place, and if you're ever in Norwich, you know, or in the area, I highly recommend a visit, you know. It's not very far from the river at all, it only took me about 10 minutes, and it's a straight path. So definitely, if you're in Norwich, visit the cathedral, because it is, it literally takes your breath away, you know. It really is an incredible place to be, and visit and have a wee wander around, you know. So I'm going to go now, because I don't want to disturb the peace too much, and I shall speak to you later if anything pops up. Okay, so until later, speak to you soon. Just try and keep the sun out of the camera lens. Okay, so we're back at the boat, and I've got to say, Norwich is it's a lovely place. You know, the cathedral was awesome. Tony and Lorna went for a wee wander around the centre while I went to the cathedral, and they seem to have enjoyed themselves as well. Got some lots of interesting bits and bobs. So so what we're going to do now is we're going to just get ourselves organised. We're going to cast off the ropes and we're going to go down to Brampton Common for the evening. It's only about an hour and a half down the river, but it'll definitely be a lot quieter than this. So you can probably hear all the traffic noise and all that. And it's a nice place to visit, but considering the peace and tranquility that we've had on the river in some of our previous moorings, this is a bit of an assault on the senses. So that is what we're going to do. So, in the meantime, we're going to get ourselves organised, and until something else happens, I'll speak to you soon. Okay.
We drank moonshine in Yes, in time.
Okay, so just a wee update on you. We are here, Brampton Common, not very far down the river from Norwich, and yeah, it's turned into once again a lovely evening. The winds, well, it's not really been very windy at all today. It ended up raining quite a wee bit earlier on, but the rain stopped, the clouds are going away, the sun's streaming in my eyes, but yeah, it's really quiet. We're just on the main river though, so we shouldn't have too many problems, and yeah, I'll just need to keep an eye on the ropes as the water levels drop, but yeah, this is really lovely, and I think it's going to be a lovely mooring tonight. I've never moored here before, so it's going to be an interesting experience, but yeah, so we're just sort of chilling and relaxing. It's actually been the earliest we've moored up all week so far. The time is currently about 25 past five. We've been here for a couple of hours, well, about an hour. About an hour and a half. We'll call it an hour and a half. We've been here, so yeah, it's lovely, and looking forward to spending the night here. Not entirely sure where we're going to go tomorrow. We will need to get a pump out. We wanted to get one at Norwich, your station, but unfortunately that one was out of action. So it's been about 3 or 4 days now. So we're going to have to take care of the icky stuff that nobody really likes talking about when it comes to boating holidays, but needs to be done. So I've had a wee look at the map and done a wee Google search and all that, and seems to be a couple of boat yards just down the river that will offer pump out, so we'll maybe just take care of that tomorrow, and that way it's done and out of the way, you know. So but other than that, we don't know what we're doing tonight, so we're just playing it by ear. But if there's any more, anything else happens of interest, I shall of course keep you informed. And if not, if it's just turned into another relaxing evening, this will be the end of day four, I think it is, day four. And in which case I shall speak to you tomorrow. But if something does happen, I'll obviously keep you, the viewer, entertained and informed of what is happening. But yeah, that's it. Lovely, lovely, lovely wee setting to spend the night. We've got a wee family over there. Just having a wee kick about on the common itself. I did go out, but it's actually very wet and muddy with all the recent rain that we've had. So my shoes are currently trying to dry off a wee bit before I bang the mud off them. So that's it. So yes, until tomorrow, or later tonight if something happens, I shall speak to you all later. Okay, bye bye. Good evening. Okay, right. I might repeat myself tomorrow. Okay. We are currently out now. We did. I'm going to really embarrass myself here, but I'm not caring. We moored at Brampton Common, and we had dinner on board the boat. It was a lovely paella that Lorna made up for us, and we decided, we was like, well, what are we going to do? Well, we decided there was a pub just down the road, or what we thought was a pub, called the Water's Edge. That's it, just behind me. And we thought, okay, well, we'll take a wee wander. It's a nice evening. The wind's died down, the rain's gone. You know, it's quite a clear night. You know, it's not too cold. So we decided to take a wee wander to the Water's Edge pub. And forgive me if I repeat myself tomorrow, but but we've come to the Water's Edge, and it was a wee bit intimidating when we walked in, because it's quite a high. Well, you walk in and it seems to be quite I won't say high class, but a quality establishment. We went in and we had a few drinks, and we got talking to the proprietor, Lee, And I've got to say, we've spent a couple of hours here, and I have to say this, the water's edge, which is located just at Bramington Common, owned by Lee, he knows his stuff. We looked at the menu, the bar menu, which runs from 12 till 3. Although I've not personally tried, I looked at the selection on offer, and then the restaurant menu, which runs from 6 till 9. And it's really high quality, beautiful, yet reasonably priced menu. And Lee knows his stuff about drinks. And it's such a lovely place to sit. We've been spending a glorious evening, you know, just talking to Lee, talking to each other, you know, just... And it's wonderful. And I would highly recommend, seriously, if you're in the Bramington, Norwich, Sirlingham areas, you know, if you're in the upper end of the Southern Broads, come here. Seriously, you know, there's moorings just outside. We've got, in fact, I'll show you this. Hold on a wee second. See that? We've actually got, he's actually got moorings outside the pub, okay? The free moorings are just down the river a wee bit. It's only took about a 5-10 minute walk, you know? And seriously, this place, okay? Lee's only been running it for about 3 years, but the transformation from what it was to what it is amazing, okay? You gotta come here. I thought the Bridge Inn at Acle was brilliant, and it is. I mean, I've eaten there. I've not yet eaten here, but just his intricate knowledge of food, is all freshly cooked. Speaking to him and some of his staff, you know, his intricate knowledge of drinks and the way they should be prepared. And put together, definitely, okay? So I'm only saying this, okay, very quickly, okay? And I apologize once again if I repeat myself tomorrow, but seriously, the Water's Edge, Bramden Common, just outside Norwich, if you're in the area, you got to visit here, okay? Because trust me, this guy, all right, he knows what he's talking about, all right? I mean, I try to trip him up with gin, okay? Because there's a certain gin, Hendrick's gin, which should only really be served with cucumber, okay? He knew it. He knew it, you know? And he's been introducing us to some stuff, you know? And honestly, the Water's Edge, Bramden Common, get down here. It's worth it, okay? If you're in the area, get visiting, because I guarantee you, you will not regret it. Alright, so that's me. Embarrassed myself enough. I'm slurring, I'm talking a lot of rubbish, I've had too much to drink, so I'm going to go away, I'm going to finish my pint, and I'm going to leave you in peace. But I just wanted to say that, okay, Water's Edge, it's definitely a worthy visit. Okay, so come see it. You won't regret it. Trust me. All right. So until later, I'll speak to you soon.